Welcome to Alive in Writing, a podcast on troubleshooting life as a writer.
I'm Shatona Havoc.
I'm April Heyman.
And I'm C.R. Rowanson. We're here.
We're alive.
And we're writing.
2, 4, 6, 8. How do we motivate? No, really, how do we motivate?
I don't know.
My brain is now gone. I have nothing. Just motivate. Just do it.
Motivate us, April.
I kind of wish I had like pom-poms and stuff.
And rattle.
Because they're totally stunned that I started with a cheer.
Too bad it's not a video. Or maybe Clark and I are thankful.
If there had been pom-poms, we would be completely speechless.
Probably.
Well, I don't know about that.
Never completely speechless. I'm sorry.
So back to motivation instead of procrastination, because we've already done that. What are we talking about today here, April?
So today we're talking about how we stay motivated. Motivation is, well, everybody kind of knows what motivation is. It's how we get ourselves to do things we either don't want to do or that we know we need to do, but we're feeling overwhelmed. What do you think motivation is?
What do you think? Well, motivation is just whatever prompts you to do something.
I know a lot of people, I think, tend to get confused between motivation and inspiration.
Yes.
Because inspiration tends to be, in my view, tends to be one thing gets you really excited, so you're really excited to do something. Whereas me, motivation is whatever force it is that gets you doing something, that is your motivation.
Yeah.
So there's actually a really good quote that I like that goes along the lines of, we are what we repeatedly do. Excellence, therefore, is not an act, but a habit. And I actually like to extend that to motivation, because motivation is its own form of habit. And I use habits as a form of motivation. It's kind of circular. So I don't know. Does that make sense to you guys, or do I need to explain that a little more?
Yeah, I think that makes a lot of sense.
It makes perfect sense. So with that, how do you stay motivated? I mean, I know you just said you use habits, but
that's pretty much all I do. I set plans and I set routine. When I have inspiration, I use that. But for the most part, it's me making it into a habit so that when I'm feeling unmotivated, I can look back. We talked about this in one of the other episodes, I think it was time management, we'll have to check, where you talked about the block and flow and the chain method.
Yes.
Where it gets really helpful for me to say, this is what I have done every day for the past month. I'm not stopping today.
So what is that saying? It takes 28 days to form a habit, which isn't true, by the way. But
no, it's not true.
No, it's not. But
it's a nice thing to think of. But the point is, you have to do it consistently.
Yeah. Well, right? Consistency is everything, really. Even if you are if you're consistent about not doing something, it's still what keeps you. It's kind of, you know, the law of inertia, right?
And that's why, like I said, I personally look at motivation more as a habit than anything else.
Right.
So
what motivates you besides your habit?
The fact that if I don't do something, it's not going to happen. End of story. I mean, it changes with things in real life, because if I don't do the dishes, my wife might decide to do them, or she might not. Don't know. But with writing, specifically with writing, if I don't write my story, it's never going to be written.
No one's ever going to read it.
Right. So there's a consequence for that action, actually.
Right.
Yeah, absolutely.
So positive and negative motivation can be intertwined.
Well, that's interesting. I hadn't thought of it that way.
Right? Well, then there's just, you've got your basic big motivators, like this is your life goal, and if you don't do this, you've just failed at your life goal.
Writing does for me.
Exactly.
But there are little motivators, you know, just that feeling of accomplishment can be a motivator.
Oh, absolutely. I do want to point out, though, because I'm the pessimist with a lot of this kind of stuff, is there going to be points where your motivation is going to fail? End of story, period. It will happen.
So you got to pick it up and do it again.
Yeah. And that's, again, that's part of the habit. It's what you consistently do, even if you don't do it one day. Actually, this reminds me of a really good, it's sort of a neuro-linguistic hack that you can use. So instead of telling yourself, I should be doing this, I didn't do this, work on building the concept of more often than not. For example, more often than not, I write every morning. And the reason that's important is because then you can not write one or two days in the week, but you haven't violated this code you have set up for yourself. And it's actually something that helps me a lot. I completely forgot about that.
Yeah, that's actually pretty... It's a good way to keep your mind focused on truth, because it's really easy to lie to ourselves. And motivation should be prompting us not to.
So what motivates you, Shatona?
Obviously, readers. My readers motivate me. You know, those emails you get that say, I saw that you put a cover up for the next one in the series. When's it going to be done? You know, or you get a post on social media. Where is the next episode? You know, I've been waiting. And, you know, those readers coming to you demanding the next one. Yeah, that's really motivating for me.
What about you, April?
Money.
Well, I love you, April. I love you.
That just killed my nice, smooth segue. But go ahead.
I'm sorry. What motivates me to keep writing? Well, money's
what motivates
nice.
You to keep talking, I guess.
Hey, you know what? Author Kathy Swanson will say the exact same thing.
So money's not a bad thing. And it's not a bad reason it's not a bad motivation to have. Right?
No, it's always nice to have. Let's face it, you need money to survive. Right. You can't keep writing if you don't survive, so ipso facto, you know?
Right. I would have to say being able to tell people honestly that I'm an author. I can point to my book on Kindle or my books on Kindle on Amazon and say, look, there I am. You can go ahead and purchase those if you want. So that is my motivation.
So being an author was a dream you had.
It is. And you know what's funny is my sister, when my first book came out, she said, at least you've been able to mark something off your bucket list. And I never really thought about it like that. It was just always something I wanted to do, and I finally was able to do it. And I continue to do it because I like doing it.
So we've kind of skirted around the issue saying we're motivated because we want to do things. So earlier I said that you'll lose your motivation. So how can we help our listeners get their motivation back? First off, I would actually like to say you will lose motivation, and that's totally okay.
Yes, absolutely. I think it's kind of unhealthy if you have this idea that it's not going to happen, because you're deceiving yourself, you're deluding yourself. And then when it does happen, I don't think that's mentally healthy.
So self-care would be important here. If you're working so hard that you can't do it anymore because you've been working too hard, that actually does kill your motivation. So it's an interesting thing. You got to balance yourself between being motivated and focusing on your work and taking care of yourself and giving you that time to recharge so that you can go back and be ready to write again.
Okay, Clark. You were just talking about this. You were talking about how you were completely unmotivated and then you realized...
Oh, yeah. So I have been traveling for a while now, and I'm going to be traveling the next couple of weeks. And I got very little sleep over the past week. And I was working on a post for my blog last night, trying to get that all squared away. It took me way longer than it usually does. It seemed horrible in my mind, and when I was done, it was past my usual bedtime, and I realized all the other stuff that I had to get done, and I about had a breakdown. So I went and I slept, and I slept for about 12 hours, which is almost twice what I usually sleep, and lo and behold, this morning I felt better.
Shocker.
So if you're really struggling, maybe you just need something basic, like sleep.
Or food. Food is mine. I forget to eat.
She gets hangry. I'm just saying. There's a reason we write at Denny's.
But to be fair, a hangry Shatona is better than an angry just about anybody else.
That's a good point. So with that, actually, there is something that, Clark, you wanted us to share with us, something that can motivate anyone.
Oh, right. So this is a website that I discovered a while ago. I'm trying to remember exactly how I did. It may have been through Tim Ferriss, one of his books, but it is called stick.com. That's stick with two K's. And unlike a lot of other motivation issues, when the carrot has failed, you go to the stick. So instead of putting in rewards that you get upon achieving your goal, you put in punishment. It's a free website. You create an account. You try and find cheerleaders and people to keep you going. But the reason it's the stick is, like I said, you put in, this is optional. I should say this isn't optional. You put in what you will lose if you fail. And that can be a number of things. Usually it's an amount of money that will be pulled off your credit card every time you fail to check in. You can set it as a lump or individual installments. But here's the real kicker. You can choose where this money goes. So it can go to a charity that you like, and then it's not that bad if you fail. Or
it's a good, bad fail.
Right. Or you can pick a charity that you despise. So that way, if you fail, not only are you losing money, your money is going to something that you disapprove of.
Yeah, that you know what? I would make sure that I, yeah.
Yeah, so I used this when I first started writing to help me build a habit, and it was effective because once it's in place, that money just starts drifting away whether you want it to or not.
And nobody likes that.
Yeah, no.
So that's stick.com. I haven't used it in a while, but I may have to go check it out for some of my goals for 2017.
I need that for Madeline right now. Yeah, I'm going, as soon as we're done here, I'm going over there, I'm putting it in, and I'm going to, you know, find some horrible charity that, you know, is out to kill buddies or something, and I'm going to...
So we may have to go all go online and create accounts so that we can just make sure that Chitona is being honest with us.
Ooh. And that's stickk.com.
That will be in the show notes.
Yes, it will. And there is something specifically for writing. It's called writerdie.com. And I've used this. I actually found it during my first NaNoWriMo. I love this program. I don't use it often. I don't use it as much as I used to. But basically, it is a word processor. Very simple program. You start typing, and you have several options. One of the options is that you get an annoying sound if you, you know, either slow down or stop. And the level of annoying sounds goes, you know, from mild to screaming baby.
Oh, God.
I know. But the kamikaze mode is even worse, where it actually start deleting your words that you've already written if you stop.
No, never.
Yes. It's a great way to just start writing if you just need to get started and get over your motivation issue for the day.
Okay, so here is my hack for this program. When you have to stop and think, just hit the period button repeatedly and then keep typing.
Oh, but I also write the word but or watermelon. Watermelon works really well. Over and over again. Okay, so this is a total side note.
Watermelon. We're going to start doing that with the show now whenever there's just a pause.
Someone in sixth grade told me that if I mouthed the word watermelon, no one could tell if I wasn't actually singing the carol at our Christmas pageant.
They were wrong. So, all right. Well, we've diverged.
So whatever you do, do not mouth watermelon to try to get out of singing. Just that's your tidbit for the day. Have a good day.
So, let's say you've lost motivation. We talked about some basics on how to get it back, just some basic healthcare stuff. Feed yourself, get some sleep. And because everybody talks about the positive reinforcement, we apparently decided to cover the negative reinforcement.
Woo!
But what else do you guys do to get you motivated?
Well, I think we have to recognize it's hard work sometimes. Motivation is sometimes it's just hard work. But you just... You know, what is your goal? I mean, we all have a goal, right? My goal right now is to finish Madeline. If I don't finish this book really, really soon, it's not going to get edited before it has to go to the blog teams, which means that, yeah, we're going to be in some serious trouble. So I have external motivation. It's really negative, but I also have positive motivation. I have readers that are chomping at the bit for this book. That's positive motivation.
So what it sounds like, actually, is it depends on what your goal is, and I guess we should have realized this when we were planning this episode, but it really depends on what you're having trouble being motivated to do. We just assumed it was writing because this is a writing podcast, but that's not necessarily fair.
Right. That's true.
Yeah, that's true.
You can commit yourself publicly. I know that we talked about stick.com where you commit to do something and people within that particular community, you know, either beat you with a stick or not. But
and I think you can link it to Facebook. I'm not sure anymore.
Okay. So another way is to just commit yourself publicly. Now, there's a couple ways you could do that. One is you can just announce on your social media, I am an author. And this is what I write.
So, and then you better write.
And then you better write. Jeff Goines, did I say that right?
Yes.
Jeff Goines.
Yes.
Wrote something called the Writer Manifesto, and he actually encourages people to announce to the world that they are an author, not a writer, not a a part-time writer, but they are an author, and that is what they do. I know someone who, I'm not going to say any Shatona names, but who has, to motivate herself, has actually put books on pre-order before they were done being written.
Like right now?
Like yeah. Right now, because I don't know anything about that.
So this is kind of specific, but something that I found really helpful when I'm struggling to write that next chapter, for me personally. So K.M. Wyland, I'm sure we've talked about her on show. We all love K.M. Wyland. She's fantastic. Anyway, she has a book outlining your novel, and in there, one of the exercises she has is write the perfect book review.
Awesome.
It's so good.
Awesome motivator.
Because then you get as excited about your book as you want other people to be. And I ended up taking this a little further when I'm struggling with chapters, like something I'm not real excited about this next chapter. I've started sitting down and writing a little summary of why this chapter is the best chapter in the book. And it gets me really excited to just get to working and get to the best part, because this is the best part of the book, right?
Right. Yeah.
So
right.
I got to write it now.
And you have to write it the best, you know, and that's a really cool motivator. And that's interesting because the perfect review from Katie was also one of the things that I heard an author talking about. I think it was at a conference. She said that she talks to herself as if she were on a TV program, you know, Good Morning America, talking about her book. She talks at, you know, as what she would say then, because it's what motivates her. Writing it down doesn't faze her, but she was talking about how I sit on the couch and I talk to, you know, whoever the, I don't remember who.
So she practices for talking to that show host.
Yes, exactly.
Nice. And
about her book. It's
and you don't want to be a liar, do you?
Right, exactly.
I find that if I have lost my motivation, that it's typically because I'm overwhelmed. I'm kind of busy. I work full time.
Kind of. Understatement much?
Oh, man.
I work full time. We homeschool our kid, and I write. And so, yeah, I'm a little busy. So I have a lot of moving items that I have to take care of on a daily and weekly basis. So when I'm feeling just a little overwhelmed by everything I have to get done, I find that focusing on one particular item, usually the low-hanging fruit, whatever is the easiest thing, if I can get just one thing done, that's enough to get me moving to the next thing. And then typically it snowballs. So I finally have cleared off a bunch of things from my plate, and I'm ready to get back to whatever it is that I was doing. Usually I use it for writing. So I got to do all this other stuff so I can start writing again.
So something else that I think is really important is trying to take some time and finding what recharges you. So the perfect review, that's just a really simple exercise that I do, but that doesn't actually recharge me. What helps me with writing more than anything else is going out and talking with other writers. So when I'm really struggling, I'll try and find these two and talk to them about anything. And actually, it's usually better if I talk about their stuff and get away from my stuff for a little bit.
Yes, talking to other people about what they're doing and what, I mean, come on. Clark and I write pretty much, you almost can't get more opposite than we write.
Christian fiction, lots of death and murder.
Yeah, no big deal, right?
those are different books,
except
by the
that
way.
I do have
death and murder in my Christian fiction.
Yeah, but it's not the same kind.
But it's not death and murder.
It's not horror, Scott.
It's not horror.
But just talking to him, I get excited about what he's doing. And I mean, this guy is an incredible writer. I keep watching him and I keep going, man, I can't wait for the world to see this stuff. And it gets me excited. I come back and I'm like, oh, I could do this and I could do that. And oh, we could... We didn't even talk about my books. It didn't matter. It motivated me because you get excited. You get built up.
Yeah, and helping these two find issues in their book, all of a sudden I'm like, that's why that chapter isn't working. I can go fix that now. Hooray.
Right, exactly.
I agree with both of you because talking to you two always...
Agreeable.
I know, we're all agreeable. We're each other's best cheerleaders.
I disagree.
But I would have to say that if you're not motivated, find out why. Is it because you're overwhelmed?
That's a really good point.
Yes. If you don't have the energy, is it because you're tired, you're hungry? Go to the source of the problem. Fix the problem, because if you don't fix the problem, you're always going to end up with the same issue, which is lack of motivation. And you don't want that.
Okay, I think we're almost out of time, but this brings me to something that's really important to me that... we may have to do a whole episode on this. It's the concept of always do your best. And I know that's overplayed and all that stuff, but I try and look at it a specific way that helps me a lot. And I think we'll have to talk about it more. But in general, it's always do your best, but do it with the understanding that the best you can do right now is not the same thing as the best you have ever done.
Or will ever do.
I never could get that through to my parents. They're like, why didn't you do your best? And I'm like, I did. And like, no, you've done better. I'm like, that day, it was the best I could do. I put everything I had into it. It wasn't enough that day. And sometimes I do that with writing. You know, I write the scene and I'm done and I got to go home. And all the way home, I'm like, oh, that was just garbage. It was horrible. It was terrible. And I wake up the next morning and guess what? Either it was garbage and it was horrible or it was terrible or I was wrong. And I read it, and I laugh, and I think it's great, and I move along.
And with that, why don't you, our beloved listeners, not our readers, maybe you are our readers, and you're still
re-listeners?
Beloved.
Re-listeners? Is that a word?
Re-listeners? I don't know, but we could come up with a word, I'm sure. Why don't you go ahead and leave us a comment about how you stay motivated or motivate others?
That is one of the best ways to get motivated, is to see how other people get motivated.
All right, well, we are out of time. This has been Alive and Writing, because sometimes that's all you have, but it's all you really need. All right, take care.
Bye.